Welcome back to Chemistry Matters, Unit 9, Kinetics and Gases. By now, you've developed your hypothesis, a representative system model, and an experimental procedure for determining the conditions that optimize the rate of reaction for the components of Alka-Seltzer in water. You should be confident that your procedure will provide accurate and reliable results. Is it easy to understand and follow? Are all appropriate safety precautions taken? Let's head back to our classroom to let you compare your work with the work of our students.
We're going to review your experimental procedures for scientific validity, clarity, and safety. Kayla and Bella, would you like to present your hypothesis, model, and procedure first?
Sure. Our hypothesis is that using a higher concentration of Alka-Seltzer in water, along with using warmer water, will increase the rate of reaction because we'll be able to increase collisions between the reactants.
Our procedure starts by making a control. We plan to fill the canister halfway with room temperature water and then add one Alka-Seltzer tablet. As soon as we put the lid on the canister, we'll time how long it takes for it to pop off.
Our next step is to repeat the procedure using the same amount of water, but two Alka-Seltzer tablets.
In the third trial, we'll keep the amount of water the same, but use hot water, and we'll use one Alka-Seltzer tablet.
I see that you included safety in your procedure too. Well done.
Yeah, we thought the lid popping off could hit someone in the eye, so safety goggles are important.
Also, the hot water could burn someone if it's too hot, so we decided not to let it reach the boiling point.
Good ideas. Can you explain your model to us?
We gave each of the reactants in Alka-Seltzer a different shape, a circle, and a square. You can see when we use two Alka-Seltzer tablets, the reactants are more concentrated, so there will be more collisions.
And when we use warm water, the molecules will have more kinetic energy. We used arrows to try and show that the molecules are moving around more.
Okay, nice thinking, Kayla and Bella. Did you consider exploring any additional variable, something other than heat and concentration?
Yes, we wanted to include stirring as a variable, like we learned about in Unit 7, because that seems like it would speed up dissolving in collisions. But we couldn't figure out how to do that while the lid is on.
You're right, that stirring does increase the rate of dissolving and reaction. Actually, any type of agitation will increase the frequency of collisions. So you could shake them, but given the parameters of this lab, that would make it difficult to control the experiment. Let's see what Dory and Aubriana have come up with for their experimental procedures.
Okay, so we tested temperature too, but we added ice water in addition to hot water.
We also thought that grinding up a tablet of Alka-Seltzer might speed up the reaction. So we're going to use a mortar and pestle to grind a tablet.
Good ideas. Can you explain why you think the ground-up tablet will react more quickly?
Each of the little pieces can collide and react when it's ground up. When it's just one piece, the molecules are all tied together and can't move around as freely.
Yeah, it's like dissolving a piece of candy in your mouth. If you chew it up, it'll dissolve faster.
Yeah, we tried to show that in our model. We think smaller particles will react more quickly because they have more surface area touching the water.
Your reasoning is correct. Smaller particles do react faster. Smaller particles expose more surface area to undergo collisions. And you're right, smaller particles also move more freely and are therefore more likely to collide with other molecules. Excellent planning by both groups. I think we're ready to gather our supplies and begin the experiment. Make sure you record and analyze your data. We'll compare results and conclusion when everyone's done.
All right, I'll grind the Alka-Seltzer.
Cool, and I'll get the water ready.
It's about 80 degrees. Do you think that's warm enough?
Yeah, it sure is.
I think we need more ice.
I got it.
I think we're ready to put the tablet in.
Put the lid on quickly.
Wow.
You're now ready to conduct your own antacid experiment. Which variables do you plan to test? I'll give you a chance to gather your supplies and conduct your own experiment. Then I'll see you back here at the top of the next video on the Unit 9 playlist so we can compare results. Don't forget to bring your data and conclusions back with you.